Hi, I'm Sandy Genovese, and welcome to the Ellison Education video series. You know, a cornucopia is really a traditional symbol of fall, and I can't remember ever a classroom where I didn't use it sometime in October and November to decorate my classroom. We have two dies that are making it really easy for you to do that. Here's the cornucopia basket, and next to it is the cornucopia food, and you can get them individually or you can get both together in a group. We're going to create a chart which made me need to use, I needed an alphabet that was really scrunched together so I could put a lot of words in a tight space, and I chose the tall and thin alphabet to do that. Now let's start by looking, if you want to create the cornucopia with the food inside for what I would think of as, you know, kind of a traditional bulletin board use, it's not difficult at all. You simply cut out of two shades of brown, and you can see here that there are perforations on the die that give you a guide for where to cut one of the portion, kind of the rolled edge of the basket. So by just following the perforations, I'm going to get that detail. And I've drawn with a pencil more of this, what almost looks like kind of a rope detail on the edge of the basket, this loose scallop. So you end up with this detail. Now I'm not going to stop to glue it down, but all I would do is line this up with the die. You can see how it's going to give you this really cool cornucopia. And then all I need to do is take a blending or a shading pen and add in just a few of the lines of the basket. It doesn't need to be everything, just giving it the sense of it. And that quick and easy, you've got the basket. Now, if you look at the food, if I take the corn, I'm going to take, and I'll leave the yellow one as the base, and then once again, I'm going to use the perforations as a guide so that I can see where I want to trim the husk or the leaf portion of the corn section of this particular die. I'm going to flip it over because it's easier to work from the back side on this side. Each time, though, I'm just using the perforations as my guide. It makes it really easy to do. This is the portion I'm going to use, so I'll go ahead and put a little bit of adhesive on this. You can see how easily it's going to layer. Remember, you cut it with the same die, so of course it's going to line up just perfectly with the yellow one that's right behind. And then, once again, if I take that same shading pen, this is a Watermark ink pen. And I'm going to go back and highlight the corn kernels, which, once again, because the die has the little blade in there, it makes it easy. You can add more if you want on your own. And then to show kind of the shading of where the leaves appear, the front and the back side. And I know, you know, from looking at a real ear of corn, there's some detail there. You can see how quickly and easily you're going to put all these together, so that when you look back at this die, all of them fully embellished. It's really cool. They're easy to do, and I've done it by layering paper, but your kids could also color with markers, with crayons, with colored pencils, whatever they have access to, and get them involved in the process. That's if you want to create a cornucopia that's like a bulletin board decoration. But I thought I would show you, if you want to create a chart, this one I've titled Favorite Foods, because the kids are going to vote for which food is their favorite in the choices that happen to be on this cornucopia die. So here I've got pumpkin, corn, apple, and grapes. And if I think about it, once kids realize that pumpkin pie is made up of pumpkin, I'm guessing this is going to be the highest number. But you just use hash marks to help them start to see that hash marks are representing numbers of students. I think I probably would also put 12 here, put 7, put the number, have them total it up to see if it matches the number of total students in the class, which in this example would be 33, and then have them understand how they could take this kind of information and begin to put it into a graph. You know, you can create a cornucopia as a bulletin board, or you can simply feature the foods in a chart that will help your students learn about the creation of a graph.